Grace and peace, everybody. What is going on? Welcome back to another vlog. Good morning. Y'all already know I'm headed to the gym. Ready to get this good workout in. But I feel pretty good this morning, not gonna lie. I slept pretty steady last night. I haven't been sleeping as good as I would like, which is not acceptable for me because I am a big sleeper. I'm big on sleep. I'm all about getting a good full night's rest. So, I don't know, I've been getting the hours, I just haven't been resting. There's a difference between, oh yeah, I slept through the night, but you didn't rest. But regardless of what, I don't even care. I put my eye cream on and all of the necessities, so I'll be all right. Friday is obviously one of those like, okay, I accomplished the week and yeah, you know, cheers to completing the week. And then Monday is like, boom, fresh start. Don't matter what happened last week, fresh start. Let's get into it. So that's where my mind goes.
It was like, hey, bro, I'm gonna be there at 6 a.m.
Yeah, that was before he went to play ball.
I was like, dang it.
Just the RDLs, so you'll be doing the RDLs, but you have a band around your waist.
Love them.
And then for the last two moves, we'll do like some active plyometric works, or like box jumps, you know, side to side jumps, stuff like that. So really make sure that you get loose. You don't want to be tight anywhere today. If you're really,
you
really
should have bottom out. Say less.
Double back, back on in my space.
I don't know why that jumps so old.
Three more reps. Two more. Last one, sit down there for 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6. Let's get it. How about the 18? Up. Good. That chest up. Up. Good. 2. Up. Oh, squeeze the leg, come up, squeeze. 5, 4, 6, 1.
Hit the star with one.
Let's go heavy today, shout it.
Grace and peace, everybody. It is the next day, and I vlogged a little bit yesterday, but not really. But I'm leaving Target at the moment, and I'm going to my studio. Whoop! Getting ready to go over there to the studio because I was telling you guys in one of my other vlogs. Oh, I done came out the wrong way. But I was telling you guys in one of my other vlogs that we will be starting to have Bible study sessions in my studio. And y'all, I am so, so excited. So tonight will be the first night of Bible study at my studio. And I'm hoping it'll be a nice turnout because I feel like I'm low-key doing a lot. Like, these are small groups. It's, you know, small group, more intimate, like Bible study sessions and stuff. And I just feel like I'm kind of doing a lot because I didn't went and bought water. I have pens and sticky notes. Like, I just went and just shopped for the Bible study. And I don't care if it's doing the most. My heart is in the right place. I'm excited and I honestly cannot wait. It's 4:09 at the moment, so I'm a little early, but I'm making great timing because I still have to order pizza and go pick that up. So this extra hour kind of gives me time to finish up some work I was already working on, but also just kind of get the studio space, you know, situated and stuff like that. I haven't been over there in about maybe like a week or so, so I know it probably needs a good sprucing up, just freshened up in there. So it'll give me some time to do that and just kind of set up everything. I have a candle and everything, so just go ahead and set the atmosphere. I really like, this was something that was prophesied before, like the studio is even what it is now, so just to see it finally starting to come to fruition is really exciting, and I just really want to see the Lord move. So yeah, that's what I'm doing. So I got a whole lot of stuff in the car, like this, and I did it kind of on a whim. So this suitcase is full of, like, it has my books, but it also has like a bunch of journals and stuff. And I've been a collector of journals for years, like years. So when I say I have so many journals, it actually doesn't make any sense. But since, you know, this might become a thing, I was like, well, I'm just gonna have some journals handy just in case somebody wants to start taking notes, or just in case someone might need a journal to, you know, take notes with and stuff. And, you know, so when they come there, they'll, you know, just bring yourself. If you have a Bible, bring your Bible. Everything else, you know, will be covered for you. And yeah. All right, you guys, I just got in. Y'all, somebody was fooling with the thing, and now I got all this stuff on my seat. Luckily, it comes off. I just have to, everything is a trial and error. No biggie, no biggie. So I have to get up on the ladder here and adjust my, thing. This thing came down. I don't know why that keeps coming down, but I have to adjust that. And then I can kind of like perfect everything, because I just have this stuff. I'm gonna also have to say, clean up after yourselves when you're using the studio space. Like,
I guess that's something I'll have to implement. I didn't think I would have to say it. Ladder here. Let's see. Crazy thing is, I do have some tape. I hate to use tape, but I need this joint to be like nice.
Now I can start sweeping up. I am so daggone excited, y'all. Not me still with my Christmas tree up. That's what I'm saying, y'all.
See if I can shake the seat and get this stuff out of it. I bought this little pompous grass thing, and when I tell you, it is the messiest piece of decor I could have ever bought. Okay.
Woo-wee. And it's from New York and Company. I bought these. I think I bought these out of the thrift store.
God, I thank you.
Hallelujah.
Good morning, everybody. Whew. Grace and peace, everybody. Good morning. I am out and about. I feel like every time I open my eyes, I am just a busy body. I have to meet designer, or I don't know what her title is. Hold on. Like event planner, designer, type of thing. I'm on my way to meet her at my studio because I wanted her to see my space at the studio, just to see if it's like, hear me out when I say this, like, of course it's worth having a grand opening and celebrating it, but I need it to make sense because my studio space is not but so big, and I don't want to try to have like a whole event in there and then we're literally like sitting on top of each other, because it worked, like the space is designed for it to be like a minimal, you know, amount of people at one time to do X, Y, and Z. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, if I'm trying to like put a bunch of people in at one time to celebrate with me, like I said, I just wanted to really make sense. And yeah, so I was like, well, before we continue and I waste time and money and I waste her time, I'm like, please just come see the space and then you let me know what you think, because yeah. Hello. Hey, I'm about maybe 3 minutes away. Did you find the building?
Yes, it's kind of like in the back.
You have people in here like at one time. It's for like a small number of people.
Yeah.
So it's like trying to get a bunch of people in here at one time. That's why I'm like, it's limited space, but it's designed for small group activity stuff.
Okay.
Well, that's the thing. I'm open to moving stuff around. The only thing I really don't care to have to take out of here is, obviously that stuff up there, I ain't fooling with that. Yeah. But the couch, I really don't want to have to take out of here. Yeah. That desk, I can take out if need be. That light can be taken down. It's just really big, so.
Did she just wake up or something?
Tell the people good morning, Gwell. And yes, y'all, I broke my phone a little bit, but that's none of your business. We're getting ready to get into the Word of God. I believe we're going to tiptoe through Judges. I'm gonna have to catch you up a little bit because I have read past what we studied together last time. Mm-hmm. What's up, Abigail?
What's up, boo?
Huh?
Why would you do that?
Why would I do what?
I think I have a couple of highlights to see.
If you break your promise, we're breaking up. Walks in the bargain, sweet things. If I wear your promise ring. Grace and peace, everybody. What is going on? I am getting ready to hop in on a meeting. I'm looking for my calendar. This is why I can't stand having up like several tabs up because I lose so much stuff doing that. Anyway, I am getting ready to hop in on this meeting. It starts at 1:00. And what day is it today? It's not January. We are in Feb. You guys, Valentine's Day is coming up. Don't know if anybody celebrates Valentine's Day. I don't necessarily celebrate Valentine's Day, but it is like the day of love or whatever, which is cute. Y'all aren't gonna be there.
I thought about going for the day though. I literally thought about going for the day just to go see you.
Well, okay. So this actually makes me feel better.
I love
my little turbo. So I pretend it's my little Lamborghini. It's really a Honda.
Yeah. So we could always walk around it.
Sure.
So yeah. So let me just see what their focus is and then I'll go from there. Cause if it's like random stuff, I probably won't then. Grace and peace, everybody. Good morning. I am doing a little bit of makeup because I wanted to go to my studio today and do some work, like some content type of work. But I'm not gonna lie, I'm having like a hard few days. Like, have not been in the best headspace. I've been like buried in the Word of God. I'm gonna explain myself here in a minute. PS is here dropping off. I bought me a desk. I'm putting on a little bit of concealer. I'm trying to see what UPS is doing. I'm about to put a different kind on, but I'm going to like explain myself because y'all are my people and I want y'all to hear me out. Because so I've been really heavy in the Word of God, and which there is absolutely no time wasted in God whatsoever. I've been fighting with myself, feeling like I don't do enough. I don't know, I just feel like I don't do enough in all these other things. So it's like when I read, I literally just get immersed in the Word. And then sometimes I really don't even want to do anything else. I fight with myself like, no, Jill, you gotta get up and do your work. And then I've been like fighting with myself with like things I've been trying to get done, and I still feel like I don't have a team of people to like help me with things, and I'm just getting frustrated because it's just something I gotta give to God in prayer, so. I'm just trying to do a little bit of like underpainting because the way my makeup has been looking lately has been weird. I've seen this girl's video, and if I can find it, I'll put it here. Well, I'll leave the link because I don't want to take away from her views and stuff. But she was talking about how like we are to die of our flesh. Like that's what we do as, you know, believers. We die of our flesh and, you know, all these things. So when she was explaining it, I was like, this makes sense because there are some days where I just feel like really, really good, you know, and then there are other days where I just kind of just hit the ground and I'm just like, dang, like why do I feel so low? You guys, I got me a new desk. I'll be able to work at my desk. I feel like for the longest time I've not been able to work at my desk. So I'm going to prop y'all up and y'all just watch as I get my new desk in order. Grace and peace, everybody. Praying all is well with all of you. Today has been a long day, but I gotta update y'all. I've been so focused on trying to get like TikTok content that I did not update my YouTube family on what the heck has been going on. So your girl broke her phone, which is so rare that ever happens. Broke my phone and I've been going back and forth with like trying to get that resolved and fixed. Finally got it fixed just to find out that the antenna inside the phone was messed up upon impact of it dropping. So I had to end up buying a new phone anyway. So also I was supposed to go to New York for New York Fashion Week. That didn't work out. There was just a lot that was happening. And then my girl Sunny got sick. So there was just a lot happening. So I'm like, I'm all for taking something as a sign. I'm like, but I really wanted to go. I have a whole bunch of schoolwork to do because surprise, surprise, I started school. And it was definitely something very sudden. But I'm really excited because this was something that I have been planning to do for a long time and that I have talked about doing this like in the past. And the last time I tried to do this, that I kind of felt like maybe it wasn't the right time, whatever, whatever. So this time I feel like it's the right time. I want to go ahead and get my foot like really into the field. And if you're an OG, then you know what field I am going into. I'm not going to stop influencing and, you know, working with brands and things like that. Obviously, that's what I do right now. But I did want to add something else under my belt. So your girl is going back to school and I'm super excited. So I have like a sociology class right now. And there's a few things I need to do. There's a couple of assignments I need to do. And I just checked my student portal. Now, it's not due till like the 5th of March. It's when the assignment is due. But I do have another assignment was added to my dashboard. So I want to go ahead and knock out these assignments that are due within the next 2 days, which I've already completed one. So I think it's just two more that I have to do. So I'm already starting on the other one. And then I have one more after that. And I think I'm caught up. Y'all, look at this. This is why I hate moving. I still have so much stuff. I did my nails too. Hold on. There we go. Yeah, I still have so much stuff to unbox. And then I end up doing my nails today. These are my natural nails. And I like how my natural nails look more than trying to do them with like the false nails on there, the fake nails or whatever. But I'm just doing these for now just to see how I like them. Okay, I'm trying to adjust something with my camera. My camera's doing something wonky. Good morning, everybody. Grace and peace to all of you. Praying all is well with all of you. Still have not gotten used to these steps, you guys. Okay, so it's my first time going to this place to get a massage. So I think I might have to fill out some paperwork or something. I don't know. But I was like, you know what? Whatever I got to do. Because I'm trying to like be more intentional with how I take care of myself. One thing I do notice is I smother myself in work sometimes and, you know, all the things that I have to do. And sometimes I feel like I don't give myself enough of a break. Like I said, I do want to be more intentional about how I take care of myself. So I kind of just want to start doing like weekly massages, if not like every other week. I told you guys I got a new phone yesterday, finally. I'm super happy about that. Woo-wee. What is up, you guys? I am doing a little bit of pitter-patting around the house at the moment. I'm trying to get myself situated for this meeting I have. It's really exciting and I'm annoyed because I was trying to take this picture and the daggone mirror is filthy. Guys, I am grocery shopping. I just left the gym, but hi. Grace and peace, you guys. I am just getting home. I was just filming like a little TikTok. I was stocking up my refrigerator because I went grocery shopping. I'm going to do so much meal prepping today. Like, I think I'm gonna go ahead and start doing it now before I even get like settled, y'all. Woo. I've been getting into the gym today. I'm so excited because I hit a new PR and 255 on my deadlift. The last time I did deadlifts, I believe I did 225 or 235, but today I got 255 And I attempted 275 and got it off the floor a little bit. I'll post the clip here. Yeah. So I'm super excited. And I remember like working out today, and I just, every single pull I was doing on the rower, I was just like, thank you, Jesus, for this body. Thank you, Lord, for the strength that you've given me. You know, just really bringing it back home as to why I can even do what I'm doing. So might not be that deep, but it's that deep for me. Not everybody can say that. Not everybody has the same opportunities as you do. So anyways, what I wanna do for meal prep, I'm gonna take you guys through the whole thing. I low-key wanna change my shirt. I don't wanna shower yet, just because, like I said, after I cook, or should I shower first and then just kind of enjoy cooking? Actually, I'll be back. I'm gonna go shower because I feel crazy. Okay, and I'm back because what I thought I was ready to do, I'm over here ready to cook and stuff, and I'm just sweaty still and no ma'am. And I have some chicken and some ground turkey, so I low key, like for food today, I think I might make my ground turkey. Everybody, happy Sunday. It's Sunday and I've been to church. I've had my family visit today, and then I've had some food. Now I'm doing some laundry. You guys, so much has been happening and I have to catch you up on so much. And I know I haven't posted a vlog in like 2 weeks. I got y'all, we back on schedule, okay? Like sometimes, I always say this, but like sometimes I have to take like a little break. Maybe I should say something, I'm sorry. But I'm always posting on some platform, whether it be TikTok, whether it be Instagram. You know, I'm on one of them. So many of you guys have been DMing me and asking me how I've been and where I'm at, and then I missed, and I've missed you guys too. Just definitely trying to do a lot at once. But you guys, let me tell y'all this. I am taking control back over myself. And what I mean by that is I'm surrendered to God and his will for my life. We got that. I'm talking about me being able to say no to things and me being able to, you know, speak up when it's something I don't want to do or something I don't want to be involved in, and I'd be scared to say no, and, you know, just things like that. I'm just taking back control of my life in that way. Be okay. And not that I haven't been okay, but hear me out. It says be okay with where you are right now, because I think with how the world is and how there's always like, oh, I just bought a house, I just had a child, I just got married, I just got engaged, I just did this and da da da. Like there's always so many like wins, which is amazing, which is great. But sometimes it can bring on thoughts of, oh my gosh, I always need to have some type of major big accomplishment like almost every day. You know what I'm saying? And that's not realistic. Whatever it is, whatever accomplishment you have, whether, you know, the world deems it as a big accomplishment or a little accomplishment, it's an accomplishment, period. So whatever that looks like in your life, just learn to like walk in that and celebrate yourself and not be so caught up on trying to do like the next thing. And I think I was like slowly falling into that because there is a lot of hype and a lot of excitement around announcing something that you did or actually doing something that you have been working so hard to do or plan to do. So when it comes down to announcing it or it actually happening, like you're kind of like on that high of, oh my goodness, this just happened. But in reality, like that does die off a little bit. Think about this, it's like getting a new car. It's like you're so hyped for the car, you wanna pick up all your friends, you wanna do this and do that. But then it's like after a while, you're kind of like, okay, like, all right, yeah, it's just, you know, it's just my car. You know, it kind of dies off a little bit. So all I'm saying is don't get so caught up on trying to do like just rest in you're doing what you need to do right now And a lot of the times we are not consistent with stuff. So focus on being consistent in the things that you have going on in your life right now. And don't worry so much about accomplishing the next big thing. Like, obviously, if you have goals and accomplishments and things you want to work towards, like, don't let nothing stop you. I'm just saying, don't get so caught up on trying to always have something big to announce or want to go ghost. And I'm talking to myself when I say this. And don't go ghost when you don't have many things going on. Some things are just, listen, I'm in the groove. I'm in purpose. There's nothing technically new going on. I'm just in purpose. I'm operating in my gifts. I'm operating in, you know, the grace that God has provided for me to do X, Y, and Z. Like, not everything is always new and exciting. And look at this, y'all. Look what I did. You know, it's not always that. So sometimes I feel like when I'm just like in my groove, when I'm just doing my day-to-day duties, and, you know, sometimes I don't feel like I don't have nothing to say sometimes. But it's like, no. Somebody left a comment and said, Jalen, like, I love when you post because, and I'm paraphrasing, so I might even be saying it wrong, but they were like, I love when you post because it just shows a level of consistency and calmness and ground and being grounded and wholesomeness and stability and just like, they just said a whole lot, and it really encouraged me because I was like, wow, like, that's what people pull from my content sometimes. And here I am overthinking if I even need to post it or not. So I'm still working. I'm not perfect, you know, like, I'm still perfecting who I am every day. Dying to this flesh every day, you guys. I'm really just, you know, working out my soul salvation, okay? And I'm really happy on this journey. And I don't know, I needed to maybe even talk about it some more, you know, but I don't know. I don't want to seem like a disappointment if I don't post. And I know I'm not a disappointment to you guys when I don't post. It's just when people do ask and they be like, hey, you're missed on, you know, YouTube or something. I can't even lie. It does make me feel bad because I'd be like, dang, it has been a little while since I said something, since I posted on YouTube. Because again, I've been active on TikTok. I've been active on Instagram. And yeah, but anyway. So you guys, I did my makeup earlier for church. And when I tell y'all, I think I'm trying on a new foundation color, and I just think I look even more, like, look at the, like, I didn't do it that well today. I'm not perfect with it, but, like, I didn't do that well today, and I don't know. But you guys, I wore my hair out today. I did a braid out, not the most perfect braid out, but I did a braid out because I have been contemplating cutting my hair again. And hear me out when I say this, I really miss, like, my short fro. I really think my short fro was the cutest thing, and I've really been loving the color. I've really been loving, like, this, you know, straightening my hair. I've really been enjoying it, but I also miss my curls. But I know how I am, like, I go back and forth. Like, when my hair is curly, I'm like, ugh, it's annoying. I want to cut it, I want to straighten it, and then I do, and then got back long. And then here I go, straightening it. And now I'm like, okay, now I want my curls back. Can never be pleased, seems. Okay, I have changed and made it downstairs. I am, so I keep my nail kit downstairs just because where I have, like, my little setup over here in the kitchen just works better for me. So I have that going on. I look really tan in the face. So this is what I'm saying. I don't think my foundations match like they used to, y'all. I don't like that. I don't like it at all. Look at my little squid. Avery, you are so cute. Y'all, look at her. Just look at her. What you doing? What you doing, boo? But yeah, see, I think I just kind of, like, went OD with my bronzer today. So I just look kind of like on the cheeks or something. I don't know. So I think that's the goal I want to go for. I want to do Frenchies. So I have this little tool, which I'll show you guys a little later, but I have this tool that makes getting the Frenchies super crispy. So I have, like, these little tools like this. I don't know if you can see. Super little. I could even do, like, cute little designs like this with dots and stuff. I want to get a little creative. Like, this is kind of like my therapy a little bit. Like, it's super nice. I love how I can create, and honestly, it was literally once upon a time that I wish I could do what I can do now with my nails. So when I say I'll be turning up with these nails, I'll be turning up. Amen. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drill my nails a little bit, and then I'm gonna have to soak them in a little bit of acetone so I can. That's the only thing about doing gel X, like after each set, you have to start over. Now I know you can, I know that you can, hold on. So yeah, I know that you can, I forgot. We are getting through the nails. I decided to go with a little longer. I'm getting ready to get my makeup done professionally. Y'all look at my face just recently broke out too. So, I mean, I know you got me, but.
Okay, would you say you have more dry skin or oily skin?
Ooh, I'm oily.
Oily? Okay. So you've already like done your skincare for the day and everything?
Technically, yes. I've done a little crying today, so I kind of wiped some off, but.
It's okay.
For the most part,
it's still glowing.
Yeah.
No, literally.
Like, for the most part, it's just definitely there.